Fireball.
We're bringing it back.
Putting the pieces together.
Say it.
Fireball.
I think Fireball
needs to sponsor the radio show as much as we give shout outs. Fireball Friday. I mean, there is nothing we don't do with Fireball in it.
Our great friend Tammy is all up in the Fireball.
Yes, absolutely.
K's all up in it.
Fireball. I mean, it's exploded. And I
am going to hear from management on Monday.
Absolutely. I will tell you this though. I want to give a big shout. You know, Tim. You know, the Houston Livestock Show and Rodeo is ending tomorrow.
Yes,
it's a great organization. It does. Graves got a lot of scholarship. Raises a lot of money. We have enjoyed tremendously, not as much as Tim, but tremendously the past 23 days of the rodeo. And Tim actually became a lifetime member yesterday.
I did.
And both he and I are going to be getting involved in the rodeo for next year. But it's a really good cause. More importantly, there's a lot of really good people that are volunteering. I want to give just a big shout out to all those individuals who made the rodeo what it is this year.
30,000 volunteers to make
that
work. Yes,
30,000 volunteers to make it work. I've got several in my office. You know, Dana Leo, one of my loan officers, and it's absolutely amazing. It's an amazing cause. It's for you know, scholarships here in Houston and the rest around.
I
want to
be on the wine committee next year. Can you make that happen?
Yes, yep. the wine committee.
The wine committee.
Yes. Well, you are a little bit of a whiner, aren't you? I forgot about that. I really want.
That's really bad.
I was there last night. They picked the grand champion steer, and the kid it was a girl who raised the grand champion steer, and that's an $80,000 scholarship for her.
Wow,
amazing!
And the reserve champion was a boy who raised you raise animals, you rear children. He raised the grand champion steer.
Right.
And it was a $40,000 scholarship for that kid. I mean, it was touching when you see it there and all the effort and the time they put into it. And I have really bought into the whole culture of the rodeo. And it's something that I think I can look forward to for the rest of my life.
I think you've taken the rodeo.
Yeah, I really have. Anyway,
we're still here with our guests. So we
yes, absolutely. So we'll Barr continue
and
on.
Stephen Trowowski.
Yes, tell us about your rodeo experience, Stephen.
Enough about talking about me. What do you think about me?
That's enough talking about my rodeo experience. What do you think about my rodeo experience?
Are you more of a funnel cake guy or a candy apple guy?
I was trying to answer somebody's question. You thought that'd be a softball question, didn't you? So anyway.
Well, if we're going to talk about contracting, we could finish the thought because do you work? I mean, because most contractors, particularly on any kind of sizable job, often there's a draw schedule, right?
There is.
Talk about that because the homeowners potential clients need to know how that works, and it's good to know.
Well. What I see people getting in trouble with many times when I visited some folks and they said, well, we gave the contractor 50% of the money or they gave, you know, so much money up front. Why did you pay the contractor anything, you know, unless you had something established in contract and you knew exactly what you're doing. And on some jobs, you know, we establish very little money, you know, to start the job. Most of the bigger jobs, it's the 30%. Somewhere in there, and you pay on a performance. We schedule things on a performance level. Once the framing's done, you pay a percentage. Once you have the mechanicals done, electrical, HVAC, things of that nature, you pay a percentage. And then at the very end of the project, you have 10% due. People say, okay, 10% due, and upon final completion, which is you take possession of the home, and your inspections, your city inspections are all approved at that point in time. It doesn't mean all the work is done. It means that 10% is due. There might still be a punch list, but that's up to you because you should have been a part of the project and participated with the contractor through the entire project to make sure that everything was to your liking.
You know, that's actually two thoughtful questions you had today there, Mr. Icon. And the fact is that I have heard those stories where I've actually talked to a remodeler who is going in and finished another remodeler's work, and they got way ahead of them. They disappeared.
That's correct.
And they were, you know, they already put up 50% of the money. And so I think, you know, performance certainly should be the way it'd be drawn like that. You're shaking, and Diane's over there shaking her head. Have you had that happen?
Yes, I've definitely heard some of my clients and some of my agents' clients who've experienced the negative scenario that you just talked about. And then having somebody like yourself who actually handles it properly, keeps the homeowner involved throughout the entire process, and has such a more positive experience.
Yeah, if you're not talking to your contractor, you're looking for a whole road of problems. I mean, you need to know what's on his mind as well and what he's thinking, and you need to be able to pick up that phone and call him at any time of the day and be able to get answers.
Yeah, and we're a state that doesn't have licensing or anything. There are certain things that HVAC has a license, plumbers have a license, but to be a general contractor or remodeler, you don't have to have a license.
Unfortunately,
that's why you have to get with somebody some experience, and then that's why I was looking for some of the criteria used for how to choose a good contractor. And I love the performance idea.
I do too.
I've already done this work. I want to be paid for this work.
That's right.
If you're paying for work in advance, there's a good chance that they might not show back up.
That's right. You know, get what you're paying for and don't pay anything ahead. I mean, if that part of that work, the performance that when you're scheduled to pay it, if that part of the performance doesn't come to your expectations, don't pay it until you get it straightened out. That's why we say, you know, 10% at the end, and people are going, yeah, but my house might be done. You should have already established everything that should have been completed upon each performance payment.
Right. Yeah. And you haven't signed off in each phase?
Yeah. Everything's invoiced. Everything is, yeah. Make sure that you're getting your invoice. Make sure you're getting your paperwork. All the checks and balances.
What's the fair point? Because I think there's a rule of thumb on small jobs particularly. I mean, if the contractor is asking you for money to buy materials, red flag. I mean, if this guy can't float the materials for you, then you have a problem. But on a great big job, maybe that's not true. So at what point, you know, is it reasonable for a contractor to ask for money for materials and whatever?
Well, you always want some kind of interest. Don't always think that the homeowners, that they're the, you know, ones not causing the issues. You know, we have problems, you know, collecting from people as well as the contractor. I mean, we've completed a certain amount of work and we're not getting paid. So it's a two-way street. It really, really is. Just to make sure that, you know, for to answer your question, yeah, you're gonna put some money up front, but it's don't give them the whole thing. It might be 10%. It might be just a 20% or 30%. You know, they're going to ask you for a certain, it's a retainer, because they're going to start to work and they're going to have so much money invested to it themselves. Right. Okay. But don't go beyond that. Don't give them, you know, don't give them the whole check. Certainly they'll not come back.
I've seen a lot of third and third and third, and that still seems like a bit much.
It is. We start out with a 30%. Most of the stuff that the items that we ask to pay for are either on a 10 or 20% level, depending on how many things are being performed in a home, what the scope of work is.
Yeah, one of my favorite answers, it depends.
Yeah.
What are we doing? What are we doing? How are we doing?
What are we doing? What are we doing?
I like contractor who has Texan season tickets. That's a big plus. Was it? I like contractors who have Texan season tickets. I find that to be a big plus.
Yeah. and I like vendors who have Texas season tickets.
Oh, wow.
That's an interesting part of the interview process. So, Cassie here. Now, last question. Do you have any tickets to any one of the sports venues around here?
It looks pretty good here.
And if you have a skybox, you know, I mean, you're probably going to get the job.
Yeah.
Wow, that's certainly a new criteria.
But everything's negotiable, said Rob Cook.
Yes, everything's negotiable.
Well, you know, I think I'll be looking for next year is, since you said so much with the rodeo, maybe we can get to talk about some season, you know, some tickets for the rodeo and some free barbecue, and I'll be really interested in that.
There you go.
There you go.
And I miss all the fun at the barbecues. You all were having a great time, and I was, you know, working hard in Scottsdale.
Well, you know, I missed most of the barbecue cook-off as well. I sponsored a big tent out there, and I had Mr. Tim O'Neill take advantage of it, along with Brett and everybody. I ended up getting the flu that week and was not able to attend.
I thought that was a tattoo that got infected. Was it
I wasn't going to talk about that on the air.
Giggity, giggity. Oh, that's right. The flu. That's what we were coming
the
up
flu,
with.
The flu. Right.
The flu. The official story.
And I'm sticking to it.
So. Anyway. Well, you know, we have one of our great sponsors here. Has been kind of quiet sitting over here.
She has, sitting right in the corner.
And Cindy Moccia with Old Republic Home Protection. I want to make sure I say that correctly.
Nobody put Cindy in the corner.
Good morning.
Welcome back. This you're now officially a two-timer.
Yes. I am. Yes. I'm a two-timer, you're but right. Don't tell my husband that.
Okay, I won't tell you. You know, we have the guy rule. We don't talk about the stuff like that.
That's right.
So, anyway, so welcome, and thank you for bringing Diane. She's a delightful
so
and a great choice, because I even responded in your email, I'm bringing on Diane. I know her.
You know everybody.
Yeah, well, yeah, that's true, too. That's true, too. So, you know, we've loved this relationship with Old Republic Home Protection, and you all have just a wonderful job of bringing on guests and things like that. So talk a little bit about your home protection plan. And
absolutely. I'm with, again, Old Republic Home Protection. We are based in San Ramon, California. We operate in 20-plus states. But as far as what I do here in the Houston area, there are four of us, and so as not to step onto each other's toes, we each work a specific territory. My specific territory is Fort Bend County, which includes Sugar Land and Katy and surrounding areas, and I take care of real estate companies and title companies even farther west up Interstate 10 all the way to Shiner, Texas.
Oh, wow.
Also, I work Northwest Houston area, Cypress area, and going west, northwest up 290 all the way up almost to Giddings, Texas.
Oh my.
Wow.
Then we hand our responsibilities off onto others that work with Old Republic up in Austin, San Antonio, and Dallas-Fort Worth areas. So we've got lots of outstanding coverage all over Texas.
And how can we reach you, by the way?
That was my question.
Hey.
Excellent question.
That came from Rob. I was
It was Rob's idea. You stole it. All right. Great question. The way to call us and order a home warranty today is by calling 800-445-6999. Again, that is 1-800-445-6999. Or look us up on our website at www.orhp.com.
Call us Old today. Republic Home
How
Protection.
How much time we got left here?
If
Very
you need
good.
Protection, call Old Republic.
How do you
okay?
like that, Terry yeah. Tool?
Telling you right now. You know, we have very little time left, but you know, we talk about relationships, and I want to really thank everybody who was on the show today. You guys were great. A lot of good information. We appreciate you having on board. Today we talk about relationships. You know, one of the things I always like to end the show with a quote, and today's no different, is a true relationship is when you walk into their house and your Wi-Fi connects automatically.
It's a new world, isn't it?
It's a new world out there. So we appreciate everybody being on board with us. But until next time, we are out.
To the Real Estate Rat Pack. The Real Estate Rat Pack is ready to answer your toughest questions. So tune in to the really big show every Saturday at 9 a.m. right here on 100.7 The Word.